Use a sharp object with a blunt end. Be sure to first show the patient the sharp and the blunt end and how it feels. Use a new pin for every patient to avoid infection. Alternate between the sharp and blunt end while touching the patient and ask her to tell you what she feels and where. For this test, use two test tubes or glasses, one with hot and one with cold water. Ask the patient to close her eyes, then let the patient touch the glass with hot or cold water. Normally, patient recognizes hot and cold water quickly. With a fine piece of cotton, touch the skin lightly and ask the patient to respond when a touch is felt and compare one area with another. Use a tuning fork of 128 Hz. Tap and place it firmly on the distal interphalangeal joint on patient's finger, then on the interphalangeal joint of the big toe. Ask the patient if she feels a vibration. If vibration sense is impaired, proceed to bony provinces like wrist, elbow, shin, patella, spinous processes, and clavicles. Catch the patient's toe by its side. Demonstrate the up and down as you move the patient toe up and down. Then tell the patient to close her eyes and respond to tell if the toe is being lifted up or down. In a similar fashion, touch position in the fingers. Discriminative sensation depends on touch and position sense. The first test we will do for discriminative sensation is pterognosis, which means ability to identify an object by feeling it. Place a common object like coin, key, pen, etc. and ask the patient to tell you what it is. Normally, the patient is quick and answers correctly. You can also test the ability to identify numbers by writing on the palm of the patient by a blunt pen or pencil. A normal person can easily identify the numbers. Use two pins and touch the patient's finger pad at two places simultaneously. Alternate between single pin and both pin stimulus. Find a minimal distance at which the patient can discriminate one from two points. Touch a point on the patient's skin, then ask the patient to open both eyes and point to the place touched. Normally, a person can do it accurately. Stimulate one side or both sides together. Ask patient where she felt the touch. Normally, both stimulus are felt. With lesions on sensory cortex, only one stimulus may be recognized. The stimulus to the opposite side of the damaged cortex is extinguished.
Est foankle clonus. With one hand, dorsiflex and plantar flex the foot. Then sharply dorsiflex the foot and maintain it in dorsiflexion. Note and feel for rhythmic oscillation between the dorsiflexion and plantar flexion.